This video introduces the migration path of Y-DNA haplogroup G, its current distribution, and the famous individuals of haplogroup G. You can also check the spread of Neolithic agriculture and the site of the ancient remains with the G gene. In the last episode, I introduced the birth region and distribution of F, a descendant of the Y-chromosome haplogroup CF. A direct descendant of F is GHIJK. GHIJK is believed to have first formed 68,500 years ago in Western Asia. TMRCA, meaning time to most recent common ancestor, is about 65,900 years ago. The direct descendants of GHIJK are haplogroup G and HIJK. Both groups formed in Western Asia 48,500 years ago. In this episode, I would like to introduce haplogroup G. Its TRMCA is estimated to be about 25,200 years ago. In the subclade of G, there are G1 with representative SNPs M342 and G2 with P287. The testing of Neolithic remains in various parts of Europe has confirmed that haplogroup G2A was the dominant lineages of Neolithic farmers and herders, who migrated from Anatolia to Europe between 9,000 and 6,000 years ago. You can check the movement path of the entire Y-chromosome haplogroup by clicking the card in the upper right corner. Nowadays, haplogroup G is found all the way from Western Europe and Northwest Africa to Central Asia, India, and East Africa. Although everywhere at low frequencies, generally between 1 and 10% of the population. The only exceptions are the Caucasus region, central and southern Italy and Sardinia, where frequencies typically range from 15% to 30% of male lineages. Based on the data from Wikipedia, let's plot the distribution of the average haplogroup G in each European country on a map. Haplogroup G has an average high frequency in the populations of Switzerland, Austria, Italy, Turkey, Cyprus, and Georgia. So, let's find out who is a famous individual with the Y-chromosome haplogroup G. I would like to introduce Ötzi as the first famous individuals with haplogroup G. Ötzi, also called the Iceman, is the natural mummy of a man who lived sometime between 3350 and 3105 BC. Ötzi was found on September 19, 1991 by two German tourists. At an elevation of 3,210 meters or 10,530 feet on the east ridge of the Finial Spitze in the Ostal Alps on the Austrian-Italian border. When the tourists, Helmut and Erika Simon, first saw the body, they both believed that they had happened upon a recently deceased mountaineer. Tissue samples from the corpse and other accompanying materials were later analyzed at several scientific institutions, and their results unequivocally concluded that the remains belonged to someone who had lived between 3359 and 3105 BCE, or some 5,000 years ago. Ötzi is believed to have been murdered due to the discovery of an arrowhead embedded in his left shoulder and various other wounds. At the time of his death, Ötzi was 160 centimeters or 5 feet 3 in tall, weighed about 50 kilograms or 110 pounds, and was about 45 years of age. Analysis of pollen, dust grains and the isotopic composition of his tooth enamel indicates that he spent his childhood near the present village of Feltherns, north of Bolzano, but later went to live in valleys about 50 kilometers or 31 miles farther north. Ötzi had a total of 61 tattoos, consisting of 19 groups of black lines ranging from 1 to 3 millimeters in thickness and 7 to 40 millimeters long. Ötzi wore a cloak made of woven grass and a coat, a belt, a pair of leggings, a loincloth and shoes, all made of leather of different skins. He also wore a bearskin cap with a leather chin strap. Ötzi's copper axe was of particular interest. His axe's haft is 60 centimeters or 24 inch long and made from carefully worked yew with a right angled crook at the shoulder, leading to the blade. The 9.5 centimeters or 3.7 inch long axe head is made of almost pure copper, produced by a combination of casting, cold forging, polishing, and sharpening. Ötzi's full genome has been sequenced. The Y-chromosome DNA of Ötzi belongs to a subclade of G, defined by the SNPs M201, P287, P15, L223 and L91. In 2001, X-rays and a CT scan revealed that Ötzi had an arrowhead lodged in his left shoulder when he died, and a matching small tear on his coat. The discovery of the arrowhead prompted researchers to theorize Ötzi died of blood loss from the wound, which would probably have been fatal even if modern medical techniques had been available. Now scientists have put a voice to the face, used a CT scan to measure the Iceman's vocal tract and synthesize the sounds it would have made. We don't know the language he spoke, but now we know the sounds he made. Besides Iceman, who among the famous individuals carries the G gene? In September 2012, archaeologists at the University of Leicester analyzed the DNA of a skeleton believed to be King Richard III of England. As a result, it was studied with a very high probability of being G2A3, a subclade of G2. Joseph Stalin, who ruled the Soviet Union from the mid-1920s until 1953, his death, was of Georgian origin and belonged to Haplogroup G2A1A. This was determined by testing his grandson. According to Genie.com, Al Capone was a member of Haplogroup G2AP303. Al Capone, sometimes known by the nickname Scarface, was an American gangster and businessman who attained notoriety during the Prohibition era, as the co-founder and boss of the Chicago outfit. Haplogroup G is known to be deeply associated with the spread of Neolithic agriculture in Europe. So, before mapping Haplogroup G from Neolithic remains, let's look at the diffusion pathways in agriculture. It was the Fertile Crescent where humans first domesticated crops and animals. In addition to this, it marks on the map where independent food was produced. Details of other independent food-producing regions will be introduced in another episode. Among these, the Fertile Crescent is an area associated with the spread of agriculture to Europe by modern humans with Haplogroup G. Home to the world's first farmers is Tel Abu Huraira. It is a prehistoric site in the upper Euphrates Valley in Syria. Grain cultivation began around 13,000 years ago, around 11,000 BC, and spread to the surrounding area around 9600 BC. Same time, traces of agriculture are also found at the site of Jericho and the Palestinian city of the West Bank. Let's look at the results of Karsten Lemon's research into the spread of agriculture in the Fertile Crescent. The diffusion of agriculture into Europe had two routes. One is the route through Anatolia and the Balkans, the other route is through Cyprus and Crete. Please see the path of diffusion throughout Europe through the map. From 10,000 BCE to 1 BCE, I mapped the area where bones with Haplogroup G were found. Among the labels displayed on the screen, the left side is a haplogroup, and the character following dash is SNPs. First, let's look at a site believed to be the remains of 10,000 to 6,000 BC. The box on the right side of the screen displays G's SNPs discovered during this period. You are now viewing information between 5999 to 5000 BCE. You are now viewing information between 4,000 4999 to 4000 BCE. Viewing information between 3999 to 3000 BCE. Information between 2999 to 2000 BCE. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and thumbs up. If you set up notifications, you can receive new video news.